varied array of horses and vehicles for you to see today. And what a lovely day we've got again, aren't we lucky? Last week it was pouring. While they're getting themselves settled, today they used a horse 4 years ago. Horses did absolutely everything. They went down the mines, they ploughed the land, they pulled carts, they delivered stuff. If you wanted to take the children out for a picnic or go to the races with your friends, out came the horse, out came the cart, and off you went. I think if my grandfather could see the number of driven horses and the number of heavy horses that have come back into popularity, he wouldn't believe it, because the horse almost died out as a plough horse or a driven horse, or even a ridden horse for that matter. The internal combustion came in and goodbye horse. But there's been a great upsurge of interest in driving. And with that interest, it means that the people who make the wheels, the cartwrights, the harness makers, the whip makers, everything has had a resurgence. So all those skills have been saved for future generations. When they've had a moment to have a little trot round and settle themselves, we'll get them into the middle of the ring and send them round one at a time. And I'll tell you a little bit about each individual horse and the vehicle it's pulling. Who's driving it? All of our horses are regularly driven or ridden or both. In fact, it's not uncommon to go out for what we call picnic drives, where you drive out somewhere, unload the horse, put two in the vehicle, carry a hay net for the horse and a picnic for yourself, and we all drive out somewhere, unhitch the horse, sit down and have a picnic while the horse eats his hay net. Perhaps one or two libations, but not too many, because we can't get drunk with the horse. And then drive back to where we started, and if we're lucky, someone provides us with tea and buns. It's a lovely way to spend a Sunday. Driving these horses there, they're in a unicorn formation, because we've got two at the back and one at the front. The one at the front, the grey, is Jimmy. The one nearest you is Buddy, and the one farthest away from you is Danny. The vehicle is a Hooded Faith, beautiful vehicle, I think bought fairly recently at Reading. The vehicle was built about the turn of the century. And the horses, Jimmy and Buddy, have been up here before. I don't think Danny's ever been up here. He certainly settled to it very well. Quite interesting, it's a different collar. Usually you have a breast collar, which is a strap across the front, or a full collar, which goes right the way around the neck and has brass hames on it. This is a sort of combination of the two. It's called a brolla. And it means that you have the advantage of the full collar in that the horse can get his shoulder up into that collar and really push on. But unlike the full collar, it is infinitely adjustable. So if your horse puts on weight, you don't have to have another collar when it gets fatter or thinner. You just do up a couple of buckles. Cumbria. Now, fell horses were bred for weight carrying. They often used to carry lead in packs, so they're very, very strong. The vehicle is a gig. There are all sorts of gigs. But basically, gigs are just two-wheeled vehicles with two people facing forward. The vehicle's a modern vehicle built on traditional lines because the traditional pattern was the best one. If it worked for all those years, there's no point in changing it. But you have the advantage of the modern materials. So you can take those wheels anywhere, over ruts and bumps and all the rest of it, and it doesn't bother them. With the older vehicles, you have to be a little bit careful and conscious of their age. Pony, Chesney. Chesney's 11.2. And if anyone doesn't understand hands, a hand is 4 inches, so that makes him about 46 inches at the shoulder. These little ponies are very, very strong, and if they're kept fit and in work, they can take two adults quite easily all day. The pony's been to Pontypridd, it's been to Ilfracombe, it's done very well in showing classes. The vehicle again is a modern vehicle built again on traditional lines. It was built by Dartmoor. And if you look, and they both fit onto each end of a bar. Now that bar swings as the pony moves, and that's because as the pony's shoulder comes forward, the bar goes with it. If it didn't have that movement, the breast collar might rub on the pony. And the last thing you want is a rubbed pony. Rubbed ponies are cross and cranky, and you don't need them. You can drive almost any sort of horse. A lot of people wonder how you stop these ponies, especially on the two-wheelers, because on the two-wheeled vehicles there are no brakes. I think I've only ever seen one two-wheeled vehicle with brakes, and we assumed that was built for very hilly country. The braking system is the arrangement of straps over its bottom that we call the britching. And if you're going downhill, the vehicle will roll towards the pony. The wide strap round its bottom will tighten onto the pony, and he can then sit back into that strap and hold the weight back. So that pony's bottom is not only your motive power, it's your braking power as well. This is Mr. Lee pulling a wagonette. These were very useful general purpose vehicles, quite common in the country. If you lived in your country house and you were having visitors to stay during the summer, they would arrive at the railway station. And you can seat several visitors in there, plus a few bits of luggage. Or if you want to go to the races or out for a picnic, you can put the food hampers up. Sit, I should think, at least four, if not six people in the back, depending on how large they are. The harness was completely made by Mandy, who is the very clever wife of gorgeous Graham down there, aren't you, Stuart? Give him a wave, Graham. Thank you. We never see him without his sunglasses on, even when it's raining. Now this is another Welsh pony. This is Fearless Fiona. She's driven by Mr. David Ball. And this little pony does everything. She's done shows and done very well in them. She does dressage. She does cones where you see them charging around very fast. And she does horse driving trials. That's what she does mostly now, is the horse driving trials. And then they have to combine dressage and cones and a cross country course where they have to go through obstacles. And I think she's thoroughly enjoying it. The vehicle is Irish made. It's a spindleback gig. It's called a spindleback because of the shape of the little railings around the back of the seat. We'll talk a bit about the whip, because this is the bit that worries most people. No, we don't beat the horse with it. For a start, most of the whips are far too expensive to break on a horse, and you don't want to upset your horse anyway. It's there to, as an indication to the horse of what you want it to do. When you ride a horse, you've got physical contact with it. You've got your heels and your hands and your seat bones and your voice. With a driven horse, you've only got the reins, the whip, and your voice. So you give it a little tap in one place to go on, and another place to move over. Now, if you want to turn right, you stick your arm out right, which is fairly obvious. But what are you going to do when you go left? You can't stick your arm out left, because if you've got a passenger in there, you're going to push him out. So you push it across your head and point it left. This lets people behind you know what you're going to do. And in a minute, when she comes up in front of the box, you'll see the sign for halt. There's a nice little brass handle on the back of this vehicle, which opens up a boot, and you can put a decent sized picnic in there, something for the pony, a few spares. Then the whip goes straight up and hold. This lets anyone behind you know where you're going to go. Because the brass on this vehicle is going to knock your eyes out. This is John Boy Vice driving a 5-year-old Hackney pony, who's also called John Boy. I don't know what happens when mother calls for dinner, whether the pony goes, the boy goes, or both of them go. Little pony's only 5 years old, and it's only its fifth show. The vehicle is a Pickering float. Beautifully done out. Nice country varnish on it. It's obviously a trade turnout. Light trade. And and this would have been your advertising. If you were in business and you had a pony and trap to do your deliveries, you want people to look at you. You want people to notice who you are. So you have a hackney that picks its feet up, shows off, and says, look what a fine pony I am. And you want your grass gleaming. And the pony done out in red, white and blue ribbons there.